Hi everyone and welcome back to another video. My name is Lucas and in this video we're gonna continue talking about Taiwanese news in international media. But as you can see, today the studio is yellow and blue because I am Swedish and a lot of you have asked me to leave my own comments as a Swede living in Taiwan on the Taiwanese related international news this week, which is something I will try to do in this video. But I should warn you that I am not an expert on comparing Sweden and Taiwan, so I think we need some expertise assistance.
Tjena! Du, jag håller på att spela en film här, jag tänkte jämföra Sverige och Taiwan lite grann. Du har inte lust att vara med, eller? Ja, bra. Men det är väl som så här att du kommer hit till min studio och så drar jag igång introt och så har du ungefär 10 sekunder på dig att komma hit. Ja, bra. Syns sen.
Welcome, or as we say in Swedish, välkommen.
Tack. Tack så mycket.
Jonas.
Ja.
For those of you who don't know and who maybe have mixed us up and thought
that
there was only one tall Swedish half blonde YouTuber here in Taiwan. Who are you?
Yeah, I can't believe they mixed us up because I'm the Swedish guy from the countryside of Dalarna. Yeah. And you are the Swedish guy grown up in the countryside of Värmland,
yes.
Taiwan.
So yeah, huge difference.
A huge distinction there. So I was living a very comfortable life in Sweden, and then I met this girl who was Taiwanese, and I fell in love with her, and I decided to give up all my life, everything I had in Sweden, and I moved to Taiwan.
And for those of you who don't know who this person is that you met in Stockholm,
yeah,
who is this?
Yeah, so she is also the YouTuber, but she's doing the makeup YouTuber, and her name is Charlie. So.
And his wife.
Yes, of course.
You ruined my script now because my next question is, what brought you to Taiwan? So I guess the answer is Charlie.
I mean, I looked like what was the way that I can go to Taiwan. And I found this scholarship by the Taiwanese mission in Sweden. And I studied Chinese for the 1 year. And since that time, I started my YouTube channel to make some videos about my trying.
Right.
Red beans, bubble tea, all this kind of thing. So it kind of took off.
If you did not get that internal joke about red beans, then you should also check out Jonah's video, because just before this one, we shot a video on his channel, which if it's not up yet, it will be soon. So after you went over, subscribe to his channel, you should check out that video as well.
Why foreigners hate the red beans?
I would say that at least among the two of us, you are more like the Swedish versus Taiwan expert. I have actually never really made any comparisons. Can you give me any pointers? What would you say is the most important thing for the Taiwanese audience to know about Sweden?
I think the first thing is like how to not offend a Swedish, you know? When me and my wife was planning to buy a new car, okay. And I say, I am Swedish, so I say, of course, I think we should buy the Volvo. It's the best car.
Yeah.
And my wife say, no, I don't want to buy a Chinese car.
What? Has nothing to do with Volvo.
Exactly.
Has nothing to do with Volvo.
So this is the one very fast way to offend a Swedish. Don't say that Swedish companies are not Swedish.
Even if they no longer are, but we all understand. I just wanted to say, because this is the first video I'm making with somewhat of a Sweden versus Taiwan theme, so I just wanted to start, before we go into the actual news for this week, I just want to do a quick roundup covering this year's top news between Sweden and Taiwan. And I just wanted to start saying that if anyone is interested learning more about Sweden, but you're located in Taiwan, I highly recommend the Facebook group Sweden in Taiwan, where you will actually see what our Swedish representatives are doing. You will have a link down in the description. Go check it out if you care. And then on the other side of the world and the spectrum, we of course also have Taiwan in Sweden. I just quickly want to give you a recap on how has Taiwan in Sweden looked like this year, so you also know what kind of impression the fellow Swedes gets about Taiwan. And the biggest news this year has of course been COVID-19 related, with a bunch of different politicians asking to stand up towards China and allowing Taiwan into WHO, which not only happens in Sweden, it's pretty much the rest of the world except China and WHO right now.
Of course it should be included because we are trying to make a World Health Organization, and this island of Taiwan is on the Earth, so it's a part of the world.
There should just be a checkbox. Are you part of the world or not? If you are, okay, you can join the World Health Organization. Yes. And then another, I think actually the most popular news they had from Taiwan in Sweden this year was an article about dealing with Corona in Sweden.
Is this my video?
they actually posted a video from a YouTuber here in Taiwan. He's explaining that they did a great job fighting for the spread of the coronavirus.
Okay, I didn't know this. Thank you for bringing this up.
Just so you know, we are now here with one of the biggest contributors to the image of Taiwan in Sweden.
That's really, really sweet for bringing that up. I didn't know that was gonna come up. Yeah.
Just on top of your head, would you say there? What's the biggest difference between Sweden and Taiwan?
The month that is really tough, I have to be honest, really tough to live here in Taiwan is from maybe June to September. So June, July, August, September. Like you go outside and you just melt. You feel like, why am I here? I should be honest. Like during those months, there are many times where I think like, why am I here?
For me personally, I would say food. Although we do have some weird ones in Sweden as well, like surströmming, which I made a video about. I know you have made a video with Adi Ingwen as well. But here in Taiwan, if we're gonna start on talking about the recent Taiwanese news, they even have, believe it or not, even more ridiculous fish, which is called the earthquake fish, which apparently only comes up to the surface right before earthquakes, hence the local name here. And recently they just found one that is close to 5 meters long.
Kind of like a Pokemon. This is such a like a mythologic creature.
I'm just grateful that this kind of earthquake fish, it's down in the dark, deep water. And speaking of something else that was down in the deep, this time deep sleep, we have another news here. It was a Taiwanese teen who woke up from a 62-day coma after he heard the words ji pai, which is fried chicken or chicken fillet in English. This news actually made it across the world. This is the global news of Taiwan right now. Taiwanese food is so delicious, so you even have to wake up from a coma to get your hands on it.
You know, Swedish food is so opposite of this. Like, you know, you eat the potato, you eat the meatballs, you eat the steak, you eat the sauce, and it's so heavy that after you eat, you go into a 62-day coma.
Exactly.
Like, this is the opposite of Swedish food, you know? It will put you in a coma. Taiwanese food, it will wake you up. Like, if I was laying in a coma for 62 days, and someone would come with a cinnamon bun.
Well, you say like coffee.
That would wake you up. But cinnamon bun, the smell, oh, I wake up, eat it, back to coma.
Go back to coma. See you in 62 days, bring me another cinnamon bun.
Yeah, exactly. But did you try this ji pai? Like, you know, you go to Shilin Night Market and they will give you a ji pai and it's
huge.
Gigantic, yeah. You can live on that for a day or 62 days.
My first year, I ate a lot of this because I had like local friends who were like bringing me around. Throwing out some free promotion here. Apparently, there's a special place in Jingmei Night Market that has like, it's like cheese as well, I think.
Okay.
Or like there's some like garlic butter or like there's some special stuff between the chicken and the fried part.
Type an Wiener Schnitzel.
Like a Wiener Schnitzel, yes, but for like chicken. And that was actually all the news we wanted to talk about here today. If you just woke up from a 62-day coma yourself or just haven't come across any one of us before, I hope that you enjoyed watching this video, that you subscribe to both the Swedes from the Swedish countryside who are tall, semi-blonde, and making YouTube videos here in Taiwan. I also hope that this video helped explaining so you actually see both of us side by side. But I am actually curious to know, because a lot of people have mixed us up and said that we look very similar. I think we should just have a poll down in the comment section. If you think that we look similar or not similar, please leave your comment below. I would love to see what the majority of you think.
To me, it's very obvious that we don't look similar.
Like, you cannot describe you without describing me. It's like,
that's true. Well, it's color of your eyes.
Yes, yeah, same. That was everything for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Lucas. Starts with L as in like, ends with S as in subscribe. Please do both, and see you all in the next one.
Oh, you don't wave.
I don't wave. I blink. Okay. That's the thing. Okay. But you can wave if you want.
Thank you. My name is Jonas. Starts with J, as in jättebra.
Jättebra. Okay, we're going Swedish.
Ends with S, as in slut. Which means something very different in Swedish than it does in English.
Yes.
Yeah.
Slut.
Okay.